Then I went on my way, didn't think about it for a couple of days. Then it hit me like lightning. Late one night, I was all out of hope and all out of fight. Couldn't fight back the tears, so I fell on my knees, saying, God, if you're there, come and rescue me.
Found love pouring down from above. Got washed in the water, washed in the blood.
God. sin was great, your love was greater. What could separate us now?
What a wonderful name it is. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a wonderful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name.
Good afternoon. Welcome today as we celebrate the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Presiding over our celebration of the liturgy today is Father Michael Cronin. For anyone who would like, there is now a worship aid on the parish website, which contains the Gloria, the Creed, and today's readings. On your phone, you can go to qasparish.org and click on Worship Aid to have those items available during Mass. The opening hymn is Make Me a Channel of Your Peace. Please stand.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. My friends, each week we are welcomed by our fellow travelers as we gather together to celebrate the Eucharist. Today we hear of a woman and her husband who offer hospitality to the prophet Elisha whenever he comes to their city, going so far as to furnish him with a place to stay. Let us furnish a place in our hearts for our Lord to stay, so that we may gain strength and nourishment on our journey to the kingdom. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sin. Lord Jesus, you died to sin once and for all. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you were raised from the dead by the glory of the Father. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the way that leads to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God,
forever and ever.
A reading from the second book of Kings. One day, Elisha came to Shunem, where there was a woman of influence who urged him to dine with her. Afterward, whenever he passed by, he used to stop there to dine. So she said to her husband, "I know that Elisha is a holy man of God. Since he visits us often, let us arrange a little room on the roof and furnish it for him with a bed, table, chair, and lamp, so that when he comes to us, he can stay there." Sometime later, Elisha arrived and stayed in the room overnight. Later, Elisha asked, "Can something be done for her?" His servant Gehazi answered, "Yes, she has no son, and her husband is getting on in years." Elisha said, "Call her." When the woman had been called and stood at the door, Elisha promised, "This time next year, you will be fondling a baby son." The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
You. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his apostles, "Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, and whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever receives a righteous man because he is a righteous man will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink because the little one is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward." The Gospel of the Lord. St. Paul's writing style is sometimes very direct, isn't it? He doesn't sugarcoat the tough message. In today's reading, he says to the Romans, "Are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death?" There, he makes it sound like he needs to wake them up to what's happening. "Are you unaware?" he says. "Do you know what your baptism was all about?" He wants the Romans to know that their baptism was all about being united to Jesus' death. Do they get it? That's what he's asking them. In one way, it may look like we live our lives as Christian backwards. We start at the end and
work our way back to the beginning. I mean, in most occupations and professions, you know, like being a doctor, a plumber, electrician, a teacher, an accountant, whatever, in order to become one, we usually start off hearing about the job or the profession, seeing someone who's already accomplished that goal, and then considering if we might want to pursue that path. And then when we decide that's what we want, there's the training and the studying and the practicing, learning from others who already have become proficient. Then usually there is studying for and passing some tests or exams and being certified or degreed, or in some cases being licensed. And then, after all that, you become a doctor or a plumber or a teacher or an accountant. That's how our job life usually works. But when it comes to being a Christian, when it comes to our faith life, it seems we do it the other way around. First, we become a Christian. It happens for most of us that we are baptized when we are infants or children. We become Christian before we do the learning and the practicing. And then we look around and see what it means. And we learn from others who are Christians. And we study and practice and decide if we want to commit ourselves to becoming a disciple. St. Paul wants us to know, wants to remind us, what it means to be baptized into Christ. Our union with Christ brings with it a dying, a kind of death like Jesus's. We're called to die to our old self, die to our sins. So we choose to change our values, to conform ourselves and our thinking and our hearts to be more like Jesus. This death may cause us to not be in agreement with some of our friends and even family members, and certainly not always in agreement with our culture. As we go along in our Christian life, we learn more and more what it means to become Christian. It's a process. And as we deepen our knowledge of and our love for the Lord, we become more aware of the challenge of our baptism, what we give up, what in us must die in order to truly follow Christ. And good old St. Paul, he also encourages us, because after he wakes us to the reality of the death involved with baptism, he adds, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. So baptism is not only about death, it's also about new life. Just as Jesus rose to new life, so will those who are baptized in him, who learn to love him, who die with him. We will rise with him to the fullness of life, to divine life, to eternal life. So let us be more aware of what our baptism involved. Our sins died with Christ, and newness of life was given to us. Stand and
together let us make our
profession of faith. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty,
the maker of heaven and earth,
of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man.
For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate.
He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe
in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church.
I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. We take the opportunity now to pray for our needs and for all those in need, trusting in the everlasting goodness of the Lord.
For the church, that we may always be willing to take up our cross and follow the Lord, no matter the cost, we pray. For those who provide leadership in government, in the workplace, and in the family, that they may shepherd their people along right paths and treat them with compassion, all who struggle or stray. That we who bear the name of Christ will work to end the sins of racism and injustice. We pray. For those most affected by global warming, those without the resources or ability to overcome the effects of natural disasters and environmental repercussions, we pray. For those communities hit hardest by the coronavirus and those who care for them, especially in hospitals at their breaking point, that we, in the name of the gospel of life, will do all we can in our daily lives for the protection and care of others with our faith ever in the Lord, we pray. For all of us, that we may grow in willingness to offer hospitality to those in need, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer from COVID-19 and all serious illnesses, especially Marie Bucaro and all of the sick of our parish, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our brothers and sisters who have passed away, especially Raymond Kim, father of Andrew Kim, Carmencita Cordero, Robert St. Ledger, mother of Manette, Roberta St. Ledger, mother of Manetta Lill, Father David Scheidler, brother of Joe and Ann Scheidler, and those who have died alone in silence due to this pandemic, we pray.
Let us pause a moment and add our own intentions in the silence of our heart. Loving God, we sing of your goodness as we bring these needs before you. Listen to our prayers and grant them according to your will. Through Christ our Lord.
Power.
and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mystery, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the paschal mystery. And so, with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. We pray. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice,
once more giving thanks,
he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
There
therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one with the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
At our Savior's command, informed by divine teaching,
we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever
and ever. The peace of the Lord be with
you all.
There'll be two lines for communion, one for each side of the church. The ushers will send each pew for communion, starting with the back and moving forward. Please sanitize your hands before receiving. While waiting in the aisle, please be sure to stand at the marked spots on the floor. When you approach the minister, leave your mask on. After receiving the body of Christ in your hand, move on to the next marked spot on the floor, about 12 feet away. Once there, remove your mask, consume the body, replace your mask, and then return to your seat.
Misfits, these liars and these thieves. There's no one unwelcome here. And that sin and shame that you brought with you, you can leave it at the door and let mercy draw you near. So come to sinners who have been redeemed, take your place beside the Savior. Sit down and be set free. Come to the table.
Come to the table.
And to the doubter, to the hero and the coward, to the prisoner and the soldier, to the young and to the older.
All who hunger, all who thirst, all the last and all the first, all the paupers and the princes, all who feel you've been forgiven,
all who dream and all who suffer, all who loved and lost another, all the chained and all the free, all who follow, all who lead, anyone who's been let down,
lost you have.
come to the table.
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever through Christ our Lord.
Please be seated. For everyone making reservations to attend masses, please note, one reservation is good for 1 to 4 people. If there is 1, 2, 3, or 4 attending, you only need a single reservation. You only have to make a second reservation if your household attending mass is more than 4 people. When it asks for quantity, it refers to the quantity of reservations, not the number of people. So most of you should only mark a quantity of 1 for up to 4 people. Thank you so much to everyone who has already purchased their United Parish Program raffle tickets. We are less than 1,000 tickets away from our goal of 3,500 raffle tickets sold. Additional prizes kick in if we meet our goal. Get your tickets today to be eligible for the next early bird drawing. Please visit the parish website at qasparish.org to purchase raffle tickets, sponsorships, and to see all the ways you can support the UPP. This is the one parish annual fundraiser, and it's crucial to meeting our operating budget and supporting all of our ministries and outreach. And this year, we need your support more than ever. No amount of participation is too small. Tickets are also available at the rectory. We are very happy to announce that beginning next Sunday, July 5th, the 7 a.m. Mass is scheduled as a drive-in Mass in our parking lot, weather and logistics permitting. The Mass has limited capacity and is especially designed for the more vulnerable members of our parish who are not comfortable attending Mass in the Basilica. Everyone who attends this Mass must arrive in a car and remain inside for the duration of Mass. We encourage you to make a reservation online for the vehicle capacity is limited. The Mass will be broadcast on a low-power FM frequency, which you can hear on your car radio. Communion will be distributed through your open car window. Please use your own hand sanitizer before receiving communion. Please see the parish website of this week's email for details and information. At the end of Mass, please remain in your pews. The ushers will release the pews one at a time from the side aisles of the church. Please follow their directions. Everyone will exit the church from the front exits on both sides. In order to move efficiently while keeping proper distance, we ask that those sitting on the left side of the church exit to the left by the Sacred Heart altar, and those sitting on the right exit to the right by the St. Joseph altar. Once released, we ask that you leave as quickly as possible so that we can get the church cleaned and sanitized. There's unfortunately no opportunity for private prayer after Mass. Weekly donations can be placed in baskets at the exits. We continue to encourage online giving at GiveCentral.org.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Mass is ended. Now go in peace to love and serve the Lord.